The long week of the Non-Aligned Movement Summit, which has been taking place in the country, has officially come to an end this evening. The summit attracted over 100 countries, including heads of states and dignitaries in Uganda, to deliberate on different issues concerning deepening cooperation. President Yoweri Museveni, the new chair of the summit, has officiated at its closing ceremony. Key in his message to the member states was the need to strengthen unity, arguing that non-aligned movement countries can no longer be described as helpless. With unity, they can still create strong markets and use the opportunity of the huge population to buy from each other.
We should promote trade among ourselves, because when I buy from you, I'm supporting your prosperity. And when you buy from me, you are supporting my prosperity. And I don't know how the Secretariat is organized of NAM and on the G77 to bring ideas of how we can promote and expand interstate trade among the NAM countries.
He advised that NAM countries should avoid the mistake like the ones which Amin did, to chase away Asians, but rather to have strategies put in place for a conducive business environment.
So therefore, it is very crucial that we study very carefully the issue of the investment climate in our respective countries. When we kicked out all these people and we came into government, we brought back, we gave back the properties.
He noted that they are to continue exploring new ways of getting financing as African countries rather than depending on the whites who have got hidden intentions. He gave an example that through the National Social Security Fund, they can be able to get affordable financing, and besides, countries like Uganda are soon pumping petroleum. They are also making vehicles that African countries need from each other.
But fortunately, we found our own petroleum here, so soon we shall be pumping out our petroleum and refining it, and that means we have got almost everything here. An educated population, the people who are making those vehicles are highly educated Ugandans. So what we really need from our African brothers, which we have been discussing with them, has been the issue of the market. But financing, there are also ways of financing. You can get a group like the National Security Fund of Uganda. It has got a lot of money. But they invest it, I don't know where. So there are ways we can, all these countries have national security, social security funds. Because I've seen them in a number of countries. How is this money used? But we are going to go for options of affordable financing.
Report compiled by Jaliat Namwaya for the news.